Hey guys, it is Mike, aka nukemz. It is Wednesday the 29th of September 2021. I have got a few days off work and today is the one day where it's not raining. So I wanted to go out, make the most of the sunshine and actually get to vlog. So the fashion event finished yesterday. I'm going to tell you all about what happened in that. There were some Shinies I really wanted and some of them I got, some of them I didn't. Some of them I tried pretty dang hard for and didn't get. But it is what it is. But yeah, today it's going to be a chill one. Going to see what happens, do some Shiny hunting. Let's go. Well guys, I'm heading into town, got off the train. It's a nice day, a bit windy, which is a bit annoying, but it is what it is. And let's go through the Fashion Week event. So I actually quite enjoyed this event. Fur fruit was introduced and it was put everywhere. Like every fourth or fifth spawn was a fur fruit. So I got almost 1,000 candies for it. I did all the trims I could. You know, they did the form change for different trims. And it was okay. I enjoyed that. I did get 100%. I think I gotcha'd a 100% fair through, which was absolutely fantastic. When it comes to shinies, I did get shiny Krogunk. I think I got a video clip of it. I might have actually gotcha'd it. I got two of them, one on my main and one on my alt. And I gotcha'd both of them within about 20 minutes of each other, which was absolutely mental. I was happy about that because I wanted the one with the cap. It looks cool. They were both awful OVs, so I flipped them. And they're both a little bit better, but nothing great. I really wanted shiny Sneasel. It came with like a backwards cap and glasses. It looked like a real like Thug Life rapper or a slam poet, some people were calling it. Looked really cool. I wanted the shiny. I did every task and every raid I could find for it, which was about 75-ish encounters, and I did not get that shiny. We also had Butterfree with a bow, which could be shiny. I checked so many of them. Did I get the shiny? Nope. We also had Blitzel, which was shiny for the first time ever, with a little costume on. Did I get one? No. So, what else did we have? We had Curlia, the evolution of Routes, Curlia. The first evolution before it goes up to Gardevoir or Gallade, and that could be shiny, and that could be shiny in the wild. And I got one of those. I was very happy with that. Shiny Curlia was pretty cool. XL grind on those was fantastic because every time you caught one, you got at least one XL candy for routes. And Gardevoir and Gallade have mega evolutions that are going to come out at some point in the future. And it's going to be really cool at some point to just completely max out a Gardevoir and Gallade to level 50 and then mega evolve them. So I got a few other shinies. At some point in this video, there's going to be like a clip over here showing the shinies I got. As for the Lake Trio, I think in my last video I showed you I got Mesprit. I got Azelf on the fourth raid. Mesprit took me 29 raids. I did get a second shiny Mesprit a week or so ago, which was 2 stars. So that one is Trade Fodder, which is cool. And then Uxie. Uxie was always awkward for the raids. The lovely Cricket 23 was hosting raid hour this morning, and on my first Uxie raid that she hosted, I got the freaking shiny. I was so happy. It's a filthy 2 star, as she would call them, but it's a shiny Uxie. I've got the Lake Trio, the Lake Guardians. I've got all three of them shiny. I am so freaking happy. Thank you, Cricket. You're amazing. So yeah, Fashion Week, I had a few shinies. Nothing massively exciting. We have a new event. I can't remember the exact title. Secrets of the Jungle, Into the Jungle. It's the tie-in to the new Netflix Pokemon animated movie that's coming out sometime soon. We're getting an event on Friday, and with this event we're going to get a research line to get the mythical Pokemon Zarud. So that should be cool. The spawns for that event don't look too great, but we'll see what happens. Maybe they'll put some spice in. But for now, we've got a couple of days of no event, and spawns can be really good. So I'm going to head through properly into town, grab some lunch, grab some shopping, and then go shiny hunting. Let's see what happens. Right, I've had a cheeky Subway for lunch. It was very nice. Now, I'm gonna go do a little lap of the pier, I think. It's gonna be windy. Audio warning. There's probably gonna be a lot of windy noises, but that's what the pier's like. It's on the sea, but it's a nice day, so I might as well go and enjoy the pier. Don't think I'll have an ice cream, but I'll have a nice walk. It's a little bit chilly, but it's nice and warm from the sun. Right, down the end of the pier. The cluster spawn is not anything to be bothered about. It's a lot of starters, nothing that can't be shiny yet. It is what it is. It's nice to get out and get some exercise. Right, I'm gonna go back to the front of the pier, back on land, and go along to another bit of the seafront where a new stop has been added. Well, guys, I went through that new area, just showed you, it's quite nice. Still being developed, obviously, but a nice little bar there. And yeah, chilled in the park. Now I'm going to start heading home. So I'm going to finish this video here. Only shiny today was the Uxie. Do you know what? I'm more than happy with that. I'm very happy with that. Don't know, as usual, when my next video will be. I'm meeting up with some friends in Brighton to do some trades and hang out and do some raids on Saturday or Sunday. So I might do a vlog then, I don't know. Raid wise, the Lake Trio are finishing on Friday at 10 a.m. and then we're gonna get Genesect with a Dowse drive, but it can't be shiny. So it's gonna be one of those ones where you don't do many, in my opinion. No shiny, not many raids. But we have got Darkrai coming back in a couple of weeks, so that should be fun. Anyways, let me know how you did with the fashion event in the comments down below. Smash that like button, and I'll see you guys some point soon. Bye guys!